One of the ways we use RF in live music is to send a microphone or direct input from an instrument from stage to the console. The transmitter is built into the actual mic or a belt pack and allows the performer to move around without being tied down by a mic cable. Now, in professional wireless systems, there can be a bunch of parts. So in this video, we're going to look at the Sennheiser Digital 6000 and take an overview of the whole system. First, we look through the typical signal chain of a wireless mic system from the capsule to the console. Then we take an overview of this Sennheiser system, which uses a transmitter, antennas, and a receiver. And then we look at how we connect to the rest of the audio system, which can be with analog or digital audio. Before we actually look at this Sennheiser mic, I want to run through the entire signal chain first, from the mic capsule all the way to the console, so we have a clear picture of how signal gets from one end to the other. In audio, we always have to consider the entire signal chain because every part affects the audio signal. So first we have the mic capsule, which picks up acoustic sound waves and transduces them into a mic level audio signal. Then it's boosted by a preamp before it's converted into a digital audio signal. Then a transmitter uses that digital information to modulate a carrier wave, which is broadcast at a specific frequency by a small built-in antenna. Another antenna, which is remotely mounted, then picks up that radio signal and uses a coaxial cable, which is a critical part of the signal chain, by the way, to connect to the receiver. This takes the digital data embedded into the carrier wave and turns it back into a digital audio signal. Now, if your console has digital inputs, you could output digital audio directly from the receiver to the console. However, quite often we use the analog outputs of the receiver to send an analog mic level signal to the channel input of the console, like I'm doing here. Now, one of the features of this Sennheiser system is that it has interchangeable mic capsules, and the capsule is really what gives the mic its individual sonic characteristics. For example, this Neumann capsule, which is condenser, is going to sound way different than this 935 capsule, which is dynamic. They are both really emulating the wired versions, and many wireless microphone systems use the same capsules and the same model number as their wired counterparts. But having all these options in one system really gives us a lot of flexibility. They have different polar patterns and different frequency responses, and this gives us a wide variety of tools to work with. Especially with vocal microphones, everybody's voice has unique qualities and microphone preferences change from singer to singer. And if we wanted to grab a direct signal from an instrument instead, or use a lavalier mic, we could use a belt pack like this, which has a connection that you could either use a quarter inch connector or a lavalier mic here. So this is a transmitter, unlike the belt pack for our IEM system, which is a receiver. So we have the transmitting antenna built in here, and this is connected to channel 2 of our Sennheiser Digital 6000 system. Now, for the receiver offstage by the console, we also need an antenna, but we have more options since we are less limited by size, and we do cover antennas more later. But with this setup, we have the Sennheiser paddle antenna back there. We actually have two of them in this room, which are omnidirectional antennas. It's connected to the receiver with a coaxial cable using BNC connectors. And again, we will look at this more later because not all cables are created equal. Now we do have to think about interfacing the receiver with our audio console. And like I said, consoles have mic pres built in. So the XLR channel inputs are typically expecting a mic level signal. But there are times when you need a line level output, and a lot of receivers do have a mic line level switch that gives you a quick, easy option right on the back of the unit. Or if you do have a digital input on your console, you can send a digital audio signal directly out of this receiver via AES. This is an XLR connector that carries two channels of digital audio, but either way, the wireless part of the system is digital, but it can output either analog or digital audio. In this video, we looked through a typical signal chain of a digital wireless mic system. Then we took an overview of the Sennheiser Digital 6000, and we discussed the connections to the console, which can be with either analog or digital audio.